Jewish Block was built in 1882 to 1883 for Friedrich and William Bush. The two-story block was built in the late 19th century commercial style with a flat roof, limestone foundation, a brick facade, stone-cut lintels and sills, and a cast iron staircase. On the upper facade, each storefront has a central pair of narrow windows with slightly wider flanking windows. All are connected by stone-cut lintels incised with geometric designs, and there is a belt course of bricks. The upper cornice has a brick corbel table like other downtown blocks. The block was completed in late 1883, and tenants moved in early 1884. There were many early tenants on both floors, including millinery, dry goods, stoneware, grocery, clothing, and boot stores on the first level, and doctors, law offices, and a printing company on the second level. But the block is most noted for housing Josephson's Men's Clothing, the oldest retail business in Red Wing. Three generations of men in the Josephson family ran the store. Founder Alfred Josephson was the son of a Stockholm, Wisconsin farmer. He attended business school in Iowa and opened his first clothing store in 1878 at the age of 20. This store was located at the corner of Main and Bush at the site of LaGrange Park by the Riverfront Center. In 1901, Josephson's Men's Clothing was opened at its current location in the Bush Block. Alfred's sons, Chester and Elliot, owned the business after Alfred's passing, and grandson Tom took over in 1959. Tom retired in 1992 when Tom Withers bought the business. Although no longer part of the Josephson family, the store's interior and culture is little changed from its opening at the turn of the century. To keep the clothing clean from chimney soot, plate glass and light oak finished cases were constructed for display and easy access. Modern heating systems have eliminated the soot, but the display cases are still in use. Hospitality, customer service, and tradition have always been hallmarks of Josephson's. Tom Josephson resisted using computers and relied on an old cash register for decades. That cash register now has a home at the Goodhue County History Center. Credit cards were not used until recently. It is said that a few years ago, a customer from out of town tried to make a $250 purchase with a credit card and was told the store was unable to process credit cards. Since the customer hadn't brought a checkbook, the clerk took his name and address, gave him the clothes and a receipt, and told him to send a check when he got home. The check arrived in 2 days. Thank you.